Now, over the past 2 years, we've been able to hold multiple camps and workshops to get girls interested and excited about STEM. We also train girls so that they can participate in robotics competitions, as well as host competitions like Math Kangaroo, and encourage our students to participate in competitions like eCyber Mission. Recently, we've also opened up a makerspace in the heart of Bethany, and this is a really great way for people in our community to get together and work on various projects in that community space. Now, these three girls are going to be talking about their eCyber Mission project. eCyber Mission is a program that's run by the Army Education Outreach Program and in cooperation with the National Science Teachers Association. And their project has qualified for nationals in Virginia in June. And so, we're really proud of them. They're going to be representing STEM4Girls, and they'll tell you more about their project.
Hello, we are the 3S. We're going to be talking about our solution for PLS. So our project is about the 2.1 million people living with limb loss today. That's about four times the population of Portland. 185,000 amputations occur every year, and this is expected to double by 2050. So with such a significant population of people suffering from the effects of amputation, we wanted to create a solution that would change the way that amputees face this challenge, particularly phantom limb sensation, or PLS. This is when an amputee feels that their missing limb is still present, resulting in periodic pains and sensations. As of today, the only treatments proven to moderately reduce PLS is mirror therapy and guided imagery. Mirror therapy is a procedure where two mirrors are placed between an amputee's functioning and missing limb, whereas guided imagery requires the amputee to visualize the missing limb rather than using a mirror. So our team wanted to develop a more effective treatment for phantom limb sensation using these foundations, which led us to inquire, how can we minimize phantom limb sensation for amputees using virtual reality technology cost effectively? So after researching our problem statement, we began prototyping our solution, which we call GLIMPS, or gesture control logic in minimizing phantom sensations effectively. It's a virtual reality application that can recognize multiple gestures from a transradial amputee and translate them into correlating movements on the virtual limb. And a transradial amputee is basically someone who's been amputated just below the elbow. We've used the Google Cardboard, the Mayo Gesture Control Technology, Unity Studio, and the Android phone to design our solution for only $215. Additionally, we shared and collaborated with Advanced Arm Dynamics, the Oregon Amputee Coalition, and Unity PDX. So our project uses the Mayo SDK to mimic the gestures made from the Mayo armband onto the Unity game. It also uses the Google VR SDK, which formats Unity games as would be seen on the Google Cardboard. Lastly, we use the Mayo Unity Android plugin, which allows the Android phone to understand Mayo's gestures. So altogether, with the phone inside the Google Cardboard, the amputee will be able to perform gestures that will be seen on the virtual limb. This will lessen their PLS by helping them sense their missing limb once again. So I'm going to show you a demonstration of how our project will work on the desktop application. It works. So as you can see here, I'm going to be moving my arm, which is using the Mayo armband, and I can make movements on the virtual arm. So I can like do interactive movements too. Like for example, my fist gesture is holding onto the cubes, and this movement and like this interaction with the objects on the screen gives like amputees a real experience of feeling their once lost limb. So we tested the accuracy in the Maya armband syncing with the virtual reality application on transradial amputees. Our data proves that our prototype can collect data from Maya's EMG pods and translate them into correlating movements on the Unity program consistently. So GLIMPSE is a national finalist for the Army Education Outreach Program eSagger Mission Competition and has also been awarded the STEM in Action grant. So we wanted to develop this solution for our community of over 22,000 amputees. About 80% of these amputees will all experience phantom limb sensation. By developing a more cost-effective treatment, we can change the way phantom limb sensation is treated in amputees today.
And that's a glimpse of our project.
On this because I have a bunch, so if you don't ask them all, I'm going to ask. And don't look to me, I'm not running this.
Very impressive
girls.
What
grade
are you in?
We're all in ninth grade.
Westview
High School.
How smart do you guys feel?
So actually, when we heard about... Oh, so we think that the question was, what inspired us to work on phantom limb sensation? Actually, we don't really know many amputees because we haven't connected with many. So when we first heard about eSagger Mission, we were just looking into problems within our community itself. And then the Maya was actually a Christmas gift for us. So that was like one of the first steps into how can we, you know, use this technology for a problem within our community. And of those, when we researched about amputees, it was this. The growing number of amputees is just so enormous and it's so important that we were just really compelled to use new technologies on it.
Yeah, and so we connected what we know about virtual reality and the Maya here, and we thought of a solution. We started researching the current treatments and what kind of challenges amputees face.
Yeah.
Do you
have a website or anything we can... How can we follow you?
STEM4Girls.org. We're actually under STEM4Girls. They're a nonprofit that supports us.
Do you see this being extended to people getting used to their prosthetics, so using new technology so people can actually better control their prosthetics?
Yeah, we're actually thinking about that. One thing that we want to plan to do in the future is make it so like the amputees, we can prepare them for getting their prosthetics by like using the prosthetic in the virtual reality simulation, so that way they don't have to have all this wait time of understanding how to use the prosthetic before they actually get the prosthetic. So that's one of the things that we're trying to implement in the future.
We also want to use this technology for patients going through physical therapy as well. Yeah.
Yeah. Can you just explain how your solution is more cost-effective and superior to just using a mirror?
So a lot of you probably heard about like the Oculus Rift and other VR. Our solution, like the mirror therapy, is a lot more effective because by using virtual reality, the amputees are actually getting to experience this virtual limb. In mirror therapy, you're looking in the mirror and you're saying, okay, my limb is here, I guess, With virtual reality, the amputee can, as you saw in the demo, the virtual reality allows the amputee to grab objects, and in the future, we're going to be using Rico Theta to make it like a personalized setting. So the amputee is like literally going to be pretty much, moving objects with their virtual limb. And another thing that, one thing with like the mirror therapy is that when you're using it, you can only do the same movements as like say your right arm. So if I move my right arm this way, then my left arm would also be moving that way. So this, although it will cost more than mirror therapy, it's like a more effective therapy for the amputees because they're getting a chance to actually like touch objects virtually and also being able to move different arms in different ways.
And also because it's a virtual environment, it's fun. It encourages the patient to keep using this treatment and helps motivate them so that they can also heal faster.
How can we help you win?
Well, I mean, there's only the national competition left, so I mean...
Oh, sorry.
Our project, we're definitely going to keep innovating and working on it, so any support would be welcome, yeah. And then we miss you filming.
Okay. When was your first time utilizing virtual reality, and did it inspire you to do this project?
Yeah, like we heard about virtual reality like a long time ago, but like it was like kind of like a dream, like, oh, that's really cool, but you know. And then when my sister, she did a speech too, actually, and there at the event, they had like virtual reality glasses, and we got to try those on, and it was like really crazy, but it wasn't until we heard about e-cyber mission that we started like thinking, oh, virtual reality is something that we could actually implement into a problem. Yeah.
How are you guys funding your project? Is there like on your website donate window or something?
Yeah, we're actually STEM4Girls completely funded our project for us, and we also, as we've mentioned, got a grant by eCyber Mission, and so that we can further develop our project, like using more advanced forms of VR as well. That's all going to be done by the grant. Yeah, in the back.
Have you guys considered doing any research around the neurological aspect of it, like doing CTs, CAT scans before and after the application of this, in regards to reducing pain and, you know, increasing mobility throughout the body?
I mean, right now this is like, it's kind of just a prototype, so we haven't been able to like really test it, like, I mean, we've tested it with several amputees, but not really past that. But in the future, if we have like the funds and everything and the resources for that, that'd be a really cool idea.
Yeah. So are you guys doing questions before and after they're using it?
Yeah, basically. We show them the solution, and then they would try it on. And then one of the amputees was able to, like, he was able to work it better than most of us.
Yeah.
So
yeah, he was really able to use it very well. Yeah.
Well, we already won the grant, which is kind of what, like, helps us to develop our project. And then at the national event, it's more just we're going to share it and then
share it with other teams and parents
and maybe win there. I don't know.
Well, that was good. Good job.